Well, this video is going to be a weird one. I can already tell that, even though this video just started for a number of reasons. One of them is the title, the other one is how I made that much money. Another one is that my voice is tired even though I just started recording this. But yeah, welcome to our NA adventure, which at this point I can name my adventure, but your entertainment. That would be a better way to put it. The show where I get to sit back, relax, and reflect upon the events of the past 1.5 week and tell you about what progress I have made since the previous episode, which was 1.5 weeks ago. So let's get started. I'm going to begin with the timeline, which is a fancy name to say that I went on the game and looked at my attendance rewards, and that said that I was online on NA for about 30 days. Since I played about 3 weekends and we get double the attendance on weekends, that means in fact I was playing for around 24 days. So as a timeline, let's say so far I played on NA for 24 days, 3.5 weeks, that's how far I got. The first point that I wanted to bring up is Dark Rifts, because honestly this is the least exciting part of what happened, you know, in this episode, more or less, because it's the same as the previous part. I basically just did rifts as soon as they spawned, one by one. The difference is that this week I realized that they are not really as profitable as I once thought they were. The first time when I started doing rifts, I actually thought they are this untapped gold mine. They give you a lot of money because the accessories were worth more back then. So I thought they are this untapped gold mine, giving you so much income for little to no effort. These days I see them differently, mainly because, as you saw from the title, I found a better way to make a lot of money for also little to no effort. So gradually throughout these 1.5 weeks I felt less and less enticed to do Dark Rifts, mainly because if you think about it, you die maybe 5 times per boss, you have to walk from the node manager back to the boss, and if you include the travel time to and back from the, you know, rift itself, you probably waste 15 or 20 minutes per each rift. And if you get unlucky to get a setup or CCL drop, then you can say goodbye to your, you know, investment, because you made a total of maybe 10 million from all of the items, which doesn't really justify the time spent and the fact that you get no experience. So because of that, I think from now on I will just bundle them together and, you know, stack them up, even though their rewards might degrade, and summon 5 of them at once or something like that. That's pretty much all I wanted to point out in terms of Dark Rifts. Now let's get into the most important part, the title of the video. How did I make 70 million per hour? Is that even possible? Can a player, a new player that doesn't even have 200 AP, possibly make 70 million per hour consistently without RNG being involved and grinding history or whatever? The answer is yes, and the answer is actually more common than you may have expected. It's Relic Scrolls, just simply Relic Scrolls. Probably some of you don't believe me, most of you don't believe me, and some of you already expected this and hate me for mentioning this in the first place, because I'm pretty sure this was your secret method of making a lot of money. But you know what they say, sharing is caring, and I was going to talk about this anyway because it's part of my progression on NA. So basically, let me get a little bit more deeper into this. Throughout this entire 1.5 weeks, I spammed a lot of relic runs. I discovered in the beginning of the week, just randomly looking at the marketplace, I just thought, why are relics selling for around 800,000 silver? They used to sell for about the same price 1 year ago, but these days with the new marketplace, the memory fragments are actually twice the value that they used to be. They are around 1.3 million each. So doesn't that mean that doing relics is an untapped gold mine that can potentially offer me a lot of money, and people for whatever reason don't know about this because the relics are not sold out on the marketplace? Well, I immediately opened the Google tab, searched one of my videos to see what 10 relics can give me as drops, did some quick maths, and yeah. The answer is, I can easily make at least 50 plus millions per hour, at least at first I thought that. So as I said, I did a lot of these runs, maybe at least 10 to 15 throughout this entire 1.5 week. I didn't record all of them, I recorded only 3 of them, you know, from start to end, how much money I spent buying the relics from the marketplace, doing the relics solo, and then selling everything back to the marketplace with a value pack. Basically, memory fragments and black stones. And I'm going to talk about those 3 runs, probably already playing in the background. I'm not sure if I can sync them, but yeah. The most important part of this is that you have to do the relics solo. Time is of the essence, the faster you do them, the more income you're going to be making. If you have to wait for someone else to summon his scrolls and get one relic, or I mean one memory fragment from that, it kind of defeats the purpose. From these 2 screenshots, you can more or less see that I can summon 10 relics on my own in about 16 minutes. These days that time is actually a little bit less, because now I can one-shot the bosses. When I started doing this I couldn't, so let's just say for a baseline I can summon 10 scrolls in 15 minutes, that would be about 40 scrolls per hour without including the travel time and the time you spent to buy them in the first place. From my clips, I can tell you that I can buy and make about 35 scrolls in 10 minutes if you want to include that downtime, but you can use it if you want or not. Anyway, from these 3 runs, the first one I summoned 35 scrolls and I got in return 70 million profit after selling the stuff back to the marketplace, so already it was looking really good. The second run was 52 scrolls summoned, and from those I got 100 million profit, and the third run was 47 scrolls, relic scrolls summoned, and 82 million profit. If I convert these to per hour to that 40 scrolls per hour rate, it would be 80 million for the first run, 76 for the second one, 69 million for the third run. It is insanely high. I can understand why you are surprised, some of you maybe, others may be angry, as I said, and honestly I personally never expected that I would ever go back to doing relic scrolls as a real thing. Like, with the current knowledge that I have, looking back 2 weeks ago when I enhanced my gear, I regret that back then I bought memory fragments from the marketplace. Now I realize how much money I was wasting, because if I knew this back then, I would have spammed relics over and over to get those memory fragments. Throughout this entire week, it got so bad that at some point I even filled my entire inventory with 65 relics, just try to do them as many of them as possible. And there's not really much to say, it's just a lot of money. I couldn't believe that for the first time in my life I managed to exploit the marketplace to a degree where I make 70 million per hour as a player that doesn't even have 200 AP. It seemed unrealistic in the beginning, but quickly became normal, and as soon as this video gets out, I'm sure I can say goodbye to this method, because I expect relics to be sold out and memory fragments to go down in price. But hey, it was nice while it lasted, you know what they say, sharing is caring, so I guess this shows that I care, or that I'm dumb enough to share this. Either one of them. In any case, it was a very, very profitable week, I can say that for sure. I ditched experience completely, I've done little to no grinding throughout these 1.5 weeks. I spent a lot of time AFK training with books actually, to get experience to push for level 60, because you know, I was feeling like I'm rich enough to afford them, now that I can make so much silver per hour. And eventually I got to level 60 at Wandering Rogues, I got to max out my awakening abilities and pretty much everything I wanted from the main 3, and now my next goal is going to be to push for level 61 to get that free ring of 14 AP, and, you know, moving on from there. I think I'm going to stop with grinding at level 61. As soon as this video is out, I will need a new method to make money. I can't really rely on relics anymore, so I will have a real excuse to grind and actually push for level 61. So let's move on from this topic, because I spent quite a lot of time just on this without talking about the real progression and not just how I make the money itself. So my Grunil helmet, the one that you've seen so far that was Pry in the previous videos, I kept on using that one for fail stacking. It seems like a cursed piece of gear because it fails over and over, and I'm glad it fails. I think it only hit duo once, and it was finally time to retire it because I had a lot of, you know, spare silver. I bought a Tet Grunil from the marketplace to replace that Pry, which I'm still keeping for fail stacking. My mindset was that I don't really need all four pieces of boss armor. I don't need that one extra attack speed from the set effect. I would rather get the much higher DP and just have that Tet helmet as an endgame piece of gear, and, you know, basically be done with my armor as soon as I get the other, you know, the gloves and the boots up to Try. Last time I left you with a suspense of, did I get a Try Crescent Ring or not? Sadly, the answer is no. I did those quests every day. I have this funny clip here to show you of a weird giant randomly spawning at catfish. If anyone knows what this is, please let me know in the comments, because I have no clue what this was. It just kept on respawning over and over at catfish, even though we would kill it. The giant, maybe it was someone's Dark Rift. We thought about that at first, but I don't think so. Anyway, I did all of the quests. I turned in the rings, the six ones, normal ones, for a duo crescent ring. I was hoping that the earring would give me a Try Narc, but, you know, fast forwarding 1 week later, I didn't get that on either, sadly. At least for this one, I have some enhancement clips of trying to get it up to Try and failing. But in the end, I turned in the 6 earrings as well for a duo Narc, and from, you know, next week after this video is done, I will hope and pray that at least I get a Try Basilisk belt. Realistically, I'm going to get a duo, but, you know, who knows. I finally got my Beg's gloves up to duo. They are no longer stuck at plus 14, and yes, I can say that it's much better to buy them at plus 15 or Pry. I was kind of stubborn to enhance them myself, and in the end, I even, you know, I was thinking, should I force them up to plus 15 or keep enhancing them up to plus 15? And in the end, I enhanced them myself up to plus 15 and wasted about the same amount of memory fragments as I would have used to force them. At least they gave me some fail stacks for, you know, try attempts, so that's good. I got my tier 2 fairy up to level 20. The skill that it gave me is the illumination one, which I guess it's nice. I never had this one before, but I will have to eventually release this one to get a new fairy. Still sitting on this tier 2 because I didn't have, you know, I didn't grind, so I didn't have materials to get new fairies. I did a couple of tries and they were all tier 1s, sadly, so I'm still sitting on a tier 2 fairy. I finished the map event, the one from the page. I'm still waiting to see what they will give us, because it says there will be a reward for those who opened every single chest, which I did, and I'm expecting to see my beautiful reward. And what else? Scalfion remodeling. Yeah, that's a good one. Not sure if this is, you know, a recent bug. I just noticed it, but apparently there are weird floating buildings in Scalfion. If you've seen some of them, you can relate to this. If not, it's just something funny to mention. I bought a Tet Blue Awakening weapon for my Meiwa. My mentality for this one was, basically, I was initially planning to buy a Tri Dandelion. I wanted that one, but then I realized, why should I waste the money on a Tri Dandy? I might want it later down the road, but since currently I'm aiming to get a full set of Tri boss level armor and weapons, The Tri Dandelion is 750 millions. The Tet Blue Awakening weapon has the same AP, has more human damage, and is 400 something millions. So it's a lot less. It's much cheaper to buy that one. I don't think I would attempt, Tet Dandelion anytime soon. If I do, I would like to have a backup. So I would rather buy this Tet now for cheap, and then later down the road, get the Dandelion and keep this Tet Blue weapon as a backup for when I keep trying to Tet the Dandy. That's why I have the Tet Blue weapon. I also bought a Tri Blue Coral earring to replace the old ones and basically finish my earring set. I have the Duo Narc and the Tri Blue Coral. For my rings, I have the Duo Crescent from the event, and I will replace the second ring once I hit level 61, so I don't really have to worry about those at all. For my belt and my necklace, I'm going to wait for the event to give me either the Duo or the Tri, Bassy and Ogre rings, so I'm not going to do any work on those as well. And as some touching points towards the end of the video, I achieved finally 500 hours spent on NA. Don't be fooled about this, I didn't play 500 hours, I spent a lot of time AFK training overnight and all of that, so probably at least half of that was AFK training, not to mention some of it was spent in those 4 or 5 days before starting this series. And that's pretty much all of the main events that happened during this week. I got a couple of workers to work on some basic nodes. I still didn't make use of my contribution points, even though I sold my fences. I think I'm going to buy them back and put them in Hydel and start farming those mushrooms or whatever for farming experience to boost that one up, at least make some use of my contribution points. But definitely for the next week, my main goal is going to be to go for level 61 and that free ring. I hope Relic Scrolls will not drop, the profits from them is not going to drop too much after people see this video, but if it does, I will just go back to grinding as my main source of income. Another quick mention, I also tried the Valencia scrolls. I did those for one run, but back when I did them, I didn't have, I was level 59, I couldn't kill the bosses fast enough to make it be faster than Relics, and in the end, it didn't seem to be profitable enough to justify doing the Valencia scrolls instead of the Relic runs. And with that being said, we reached the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, I hope you learned something new. Please don't abuse the Relic Scroll thingies because I want to make some money as well. People will abuse them anyway. There's nothing I can do about that, but yeah. I will see you in the next part. Until then, stay happy, and stay happy. Bye.